we want to determine the four function values using the provided tables. Notice how this table gives us the x values and the function values for function f. Remember, we can also think of the x values as the inputs, and the function values or y values as the outputs. And the second table does the same, but for function g. So we're first given f plus g of 2, which using our definitions here on the right is equivalent to f of 2 plus g of 2. So to determine the value of f of 2, we want to find the function value or output when the input or the x value is positive 2. So we can say f of the input is equal to the output. So again, in both cases, the x values would be the inputs, and the y values or function values would be the outputs. So for f of 2, notice our function f, when the x value or input is positive 2, the output is negative 1. So f of 2 is equal to negative 1. And then for function g, notice when the input or x value is positive 2, the output or function value is 11. So we have negative 1 plus 11, which is equal to 10. For f minus g of negative 3, this would be equivalent to f of negative 3 minus g of negative 3. Going back to the table for f, notice when the x value or input is negative 3, the output or function value is positive 4. So we'd have positive 4 minus, and then for g of negative 3, notice when the input or x value is negative 3 for g, the function value or output is positive 6. So f of negative 3 minus g of negative 3 is equal to 4 minus 6, which is equal to negative 2. Next we have f times g of 1, which is equivalent to f of 1 times g of 1. So for f of 1, notice that for function f, when the input is positive 1, the output or function value is negative 4. So here we have negative 4 times. For g of 1, notice when the input is 1, the function value or output is positive 6. So f of 1 times g of 1 is equal to negative 4 times 6, which is equal to negative 24. And then finally we have f divided by g of negative 1, which is equivalent to f of negative 1 divided by g of negative 1. For f of negative 1, notice that when the input or x value is negative 1 for function f, the output is negative 4. So here we have negative 4 divided by, for g of negative 1, notice that for g, when the input is negative 1, the output is positive 2. So f of negative 1 divided by g of negative 1 is equal to negative 4 divided by 2, which is equal to negative 2. I hope you found this explanation helpful.